66 million years ago, a flaming asteroid collided with our planet. When this giant object slammed into Earth, it triggered one of the most devastating events in our planet's history, known as the Cretaceous-Paleogene, or KPG, extinction. This extinction event rapidly devastated Earth's biosphere and eradicated roughly 75% of species, including all non-avian dinosaurs. Giant reptiles like Tyrannosaurus rex never again walked the Earth. But this rare event also began a new era, dominated by modern life. The KPG extinction marks the boundary between the Cretaceous period and the Paleogene period, the first of the Cenozoic era. It's safe to say the Paleogene began with a rocky start. The asteroid impact that wiped out the dinosaurs triggered an ecological domino effect that wreaked havoc on Earth's ecosystems. Natural disasters like tsunamis and wildfires raged across coastlines and forests. Enough dust and debris were launched into the atmosphere to cause an impact winter that swallowed much of our planet in darkness. Photosynthetic plants that relied on sunlight for energy died out, and many of the world's richest ecosystems crumbled. Herbivores and carnivores alike struggled to survive in this volatile, dangerous world. Pterosaurs, marine reptiles, and non-avian dinosaurs were some of the many species unable to adapt in this dark and cold chapter of our planet's history. Soon, the dust and darkness cleared, and the impact winter gave way to a period of warming. Greenhouse gases released by volcanic activity accrued in the atmosphere, raising global temperatures and creating a more tropical climate, especially around the equator. This warming period caused significant ecological transformations as new species began to dominate the globe. During the Cretaceous period, many common plants were gymnosperms, or seed-producing plants, like early conifers. For millions of years, gymnosperms grew in vast prehistoric forests and murky swamps, forming dense yet open ecosystems where reptiles and amphibians thrived. The same plants struggled to adapt to harsher conditions after the KPG extinction event. As gymnosperms declined, angiosperms, or flowering plants, filled the niches they left behind. These colorful flora survived thanks to important evolutionary innovations like flowers and fruits, which attracted pollinators of all shapes and sizes. As flowering plants became abundant and diverse, they formed complex jungle-like canopies known as rainforests. These tropical ecosystems developed mostly around the equator, in modern-day South America, Southeast Asia, and parts of Africa. Within the rainforests, diverse plant and animal species created unique ecological communities. To this day, rainforests remain some of the richest and most biodiverse ecosystems in the world, housing between 50% and 75% of all biotic species. Like angiosperms replaced gymnosperms, non-avian dinosaurs were largely succeeded by new kinds of mammals, which began to dominate terrestrial ecosystems. The first mammals actually emerged millions of years earlier, but during the Paleogene, they grew and diversified like never before. Unlike many dinosaurs, which were large and specialized, early mammals were smaller and more flexible. Many species, like early marsupials, could easily adjust their diets and habitats, allowing them to survive during this period of ecological turmoil. When the dust finally settled, small mammals were among the most populous creatures left on Earth. These resourceful survivors prospered in the world's growing rainforests and enabled the development of angiosperms by pollinating flowers and spreading seeds. Over time, mammals not only ballooned in numbers, but also explored a range of diets, sizes, and body types. Some became insectivores, feeding on abundant tropical insects. Others adapted a more herbivorous diet, dining on leaves, flowers, and fruits. Food webs gradually stabilized in and out of the tropics, and several important lineages began, like the first ungulates or hoofed animals. Primitive ungulates survived and grew after the KPG extinction thanks to evolutionary innovations like specialized teeth for chewing and grinding vegetation. Ungulates would become staple grazers and browsers in many ecosystems, but they also served as prey animals for a new class of carnivores. The relatives of modern-day dogs, cats, and bears, known as carnivorans, emerged during the Paleogene period, about 60 million years ago. The first species were probably small, generalist predators, but over time they developed bigger bodies, sharper teeth, and specialized claws for grasping and shearing meat. These carnivorans largely succeeded in the absence of non-avian dinosaurs. Had giant reptiles like T-Rex still walked the Earth, lineages like canines and felines may not have prospered the way they did. With non-avian dinosaurs extinct, carnivorans freely hunted, reproduced, and diversified. Many became apex predators and keystone species in their respective ecosystems. Some hunted like ambush predators, hiding among trees and dense brush, while others chased their prey across open forests and plains, similar to African big cats. While not as widespread as ungulates or carnivorans, other important species could be found climbing in the trees. According to our fossil record, the earliest known primates emerged in primitive rainforests during the Paleogene period. These unique animals likely spent their time in the forest canopy, enjoying the rich diversity of fruits and insects. Over millions of years, early primates would develop key evolutionary traits, like grasping hands, forward-facing eyes, and larger brains, all characteristic of primates today. After just a few million years, the age of mammals was well underway, forcing the remaining avian dinosaurs to change and adapt. A common misconception is that every dinosaur relative was eradicated during the KPG extinction event. All non-avian dinosaurs were destroyed, but some small flying relatives managed to survive. These species, which we call birds, first emerged during the Jurassic period about 150 million years ago. Species like Archaeopteryx had dinosaur-like teeth and bony tails, along with avian qualities like wings, feathers, and wishbones. Thanks to their mobility and adaptability, avian dinosaurs survived into the Paleogene period and filled vacant niches in tropical ecosystems around the equator. Most of these surviving birds were small, nimble flyers. They darted between branches, hunting flying insects or gathering vibrant fruit. As these birds spread to new ecosystems, they would diversify into hundreds of families and thousands of species. The recovery of terrestrial plants and animals, like mammals and birds, took several million years. But according to the fossil record, marine ecosystems resurged much more quickly. Among the species most impacted by the KPG extinction event were tiny marine organisms called phytoplankton. During the impact winter, which shrouded the surface in darkness, phytoplankton were unable to produce food, and as a result, some groups suffered significant declines. These minuscule organisms were the foundation of many aquatic food chains. As their population declined, a rippling effect spread through the entire ocean, causing many animals to disappear entirely. Once abundant creatures like ammonites suddenly perished, alongside many well-known marine reptiles. Underwater giants like mosasaurs and plesiosaurs simply could not survive in this new world and disappeared from the fossil record around 66 million years ago. These marine reptiles would never return, but as the planet warmed, marine ecosystems did eventually resurge. Populations of phytoplankton steadily increased, and food webs formed around new flora and fauna. Some of the first aquatic angiosperms, known as seagrasses, created lush meadows that provided food and shelter for a wide variety of animals. In these blossoming ecosystems, ray-finned fishes, like elopiforms, became especially populous. Elopiforms were strong swimmers who used their long bodies and forked tails to produce bursts of speed and sometimes leap from the water. As populations of prey fish increased, predators like sharks also grew and diversified. Many shark species filled the open niches left by marine reptiles, becoming top predators in their food chains. But sharks faced stiff competition from some unexpected adversaries. Roughly 50 million years ago, certain land-dwelling animals gradually shifted from a terrestrial to an aquatic lifestyle. These animals underwent significant anatomical transformations over millions of years to make this transition from land to sea. In place of stocky limbs and toed feet, they evolved streamlined bodies, paddle-like forelimbs, and flattened tails. Some of the first mammals to live underwater were likely the ancestors of modern cetaceans, like whales and dolphins. Before they swam effortlessly underwater, cetaceans evolved from terrestrial ungulates that slowly adapted to an amphibious lifestyle. One of the earliest cetaceans was Ambulocetus, also known as the walking whale. Ambulocetus was likely semi-aquatic, reproducing on land while feeding underwater. It probably swam by undulating its long body, similar to modern-day otters and crocodiles. Though related to some of the largest mammals ever, Ambulocetus was about the size of a sea lion and spent most of its life along the water's edge. As mammals gradually transitioned between land and sea, our planet experienced another period of radical climate change. About 56 million years ago, massive amounts of carbon were released into the atmosphere, increasing global temperatures by about 5 to 8 degrees Celsius. This period of warming, known as the Paleocene-Eocene Thermal Maximum, or PETM, was likely caused by a combination of natural factors. Geological activity likely released methane hydrates beneath the ocean floor. At the same time, volcanic eruptions in the North Atlantic may have injected CO2 into the atmosphere. Together, these greenhouse gases increased global warming for about 200,000 years and kick-started yet another wave of ecological transformations. As temperatures increased, the tropics grew, triggering bursts of evolution among flora and fauna. Though great for some animals, not all species could tolerate the warmer conditions around the equator. Many animals migrated toward higher latitudes and altitudes in places like modern-day North America. Carnivorans, primates, and hoofed animals colonized these cooler environments, where they evolved larger bodies and thicker coats. Many birds also migrated toward the poles, finding areas with less competition and more resources. As these populations migrated and mixed, ancestral species radiated into multitudes of new lineages, many of which still exist today. Across geological time, a single event can have cascading consequences that influence the evolution of species and ecosystems around the world. Events like the KPG extinction and the PETM destroyed environments and decimated populations. However, they also created opportunities, forcing innovations that molded the future of life on our planet. Without these events, modern birds, mammals, and flowering plants may not look or exist as they do today. Animals like non-avian dinosaurs may have gone extinct, but their disappearance paved the way for a whole new world of life.